And the excitement we saw earlier tonight in College Park, Maryland. Liberty University, a small school in Lynchburg, Virginia, founded in 1971 by Jerry Falwell, the religious leader who is now the chancellor of that university, never won a tournament game before this year. Won the first round of the NCAA Women's Championship against Penn State, and then trying to go to the Sweet 16, taking on DePaul. Katie Feenstra, 6'8 inside, putting Liberty up 51-41. Odette Towers, the steal. Jenny Dant, she led DePaul on a run, 16-0 run that gave DePaul the lead.
Jenny Dant, big time three-pointer. She carried them like she carried them in the first round. But I'll tell you what, that girl right there, Crystal Tharp, was too much running the point. And Katie Feenstra, how are you going to guard her? She keeps the ball high. She uses a glass, Lisa.
You know what I love about Katie Feenstra? She keeps it so high. She turns around. When the defense comes in to double and help, they're not effective. At 6'8", she does a great job of finishing inside.
88-79, Liberty beats DePaul. I mentioned that 16-0 DePaul run. Immediately on the heels of that, after the Blue Demons had used that to take a six-point lead, Liberty, Kerry Green called timeout, and they went on a 21-3 run to answer it. Liberty, the Lady Flames, putting it away and going into the Sweet 16 for the first time in school history, and only the second time in the history of the Women's Championship that a 13 seed has made the round of 16. And there was no tournament history before this year for Liberty. There was no tournament history for their conference. First tournament win for the Big South. In fact, out of the 30 conferences, only two now remain winless. The Big South getting its first win. This has been the typical, stereotypical, cliched Cinderella story almost.
You know what's interesting though, Reese? This is a 13 seed that was just better than DePaul. This 13 seed shouldn't be a 13 seed. They're a 13 seed because they play in the Big South Conference. This is a team that could compete. How is LSU going to guard the 6'8 big girl in the middle?
I think they're going to double team with the post. I think because she's 6'8", most teams have been double teaming with a guard. If you bring two post players to her, she's going to have Sylvia Fowles, who's 6'5", coming off the bench for LSU. I think she'll have more trouble playing against a more athletic team. It'll be interesting to see how they respond.
You know, Kerry Green, he's scheduled tough. This Liberty team did go and beat Kansas State, albeit without Kendra Wecker in Manhattan, so toughened them up with a tough schedule, and they are reaping the dividends by going to the Sweet 16. Sweet